This video is called Find the Exact Area and Perimeter of the Parallelogram 2. So in this problem, we are going to find perimeter of the parallelogram and area of the parallelogram. So again, remember, just perimeter is adding up all of the sides of the parallelogram, and area, the formula that we know is area is base times height, where it's very important to remember that you pick the base and the height carefully. They have to be perpendicular. Well, let's start with perimeter. I think we'll actually get this one done very quickly. If you can remember back in chapter 6, the properties of a parallelogram, one of the properties is that opposite sides are congruent. So if the top is 20, the bottom's 20, the right's 30, the left is 30. So the perimeter is simply going to be 20 plus 30 plus 20 plus 30, which gives us 100 units. So that took care of that actually very quickly. All right, so then let's go ahead and look at area. Well, area is base times height. Let's pick our base and pick our height. They have to be perpendicular, so I don't think I want to pick this because I don't have a imaginary line to drop down. Or I could, but it looks like they already did one for me. If we picked this as our base, this dotted line that drew in could be considered our height because it's already marked as being perpendicular. So I think that is the route I'm going to take. So I already have my base as 30. Now I just need to spend some time finding the height, that imaginary line, and once I do that, I'll be set. Well, looking at that, it's kind of hard to know what to do, but school day is done. It's kind of hard to know where to start, so you have to really look and think about what you're given. We gave you a 60-degree angle down here in the bottom right of our parallelogram. Well, another property of parallelograms was that opposite angles are congruent. So if the lower right is 60, the upper left is going to be 60. I know I have a 90-degree angle here, so I've got a special right triangle where if this is 60, this is 90. Well, then that must be 30. I'm going to redraw this down here so we can orient it in a way that we're more familiar with, where we've got the 90, we've got the 60, we've got the 30. And it looks like all we know is that this hypotenuse is 20. So let's think about it. Which side am I caring about? I'm caring about this side because this is the height. This is that dotted line in the picture. So hold on. So once we can, all right, sorry about that. So we're on our 30, 60, 90. We want to find the long leg, the dotted line, because that will be the height, which is what we need for our formula. So I remember opposite my 30 is n, opposite my 60 is n root 3, opposite my 90 is 2n. So which side do we have something we can work with? Right here. That hypotenuse is represented by 2n, and we're also told it's 20, so 2n equals 20. So when you divide both sides by 2, we get n to be 10. So that makes the short leg 10 and the long leg 10 root 3. Sorry about this, lots of announcements. All right, so on this picture, it puts this little guy as 10, that's as 20, and my imaginary line, my height, is 10 root 3. So the height is the one I need is the 10 root 3. So I'll put that into my formula. The base was 30. The height was 10 root 3. Since it's multiplication, we are allowed to combine these to be 30 times 10 is 300. So we have 300 root 3, and we label our answer units squared because we were finding area. So the perimeter of this parallelogram is 100 units. The area is 300 root 3 units squared.